In 1935, a single-thought experiment turned our understanding of reality upside down. It posed such a disturbing question that physicists still debate it today. Can something be both alive and dead at the same time? This is not philosophy, it is quantum mechanics. Erwin Schrödinger did not intend to break physics with this experiment. Instead, he wanted to fix it. At a time when Einstein called quantum theory spooky, Schrödinger chose to confront this fear head-on. This is the story of how a cat in a box became a battlefield for the soul of the universe, and why, nearly 100 years later, we are still chasing its ghost. To understand why Schrödinger's cat became the main symbol of quantum weirdness, we need to go back to a time when the science was at war with itself. Erwin Schrödinger was born in 1887 in Vienna, Austria. His love for science was influenced by his father, who had a deep interest in scientific discoveries. Growing up in an environment filled with discussions about nature, experiments, and the wonders of the universe, young Erwin developed a strong desire for logical thinking and problem solving. When he entered the University of Vienna, Schrödinger stepped into the world of theoretical physics. There, he met two mentors who would shape his future, Franz Exner and Friedrich Hasenerl. These professors didn't just teach him formulas. They encouraged him to ask big questions, challenge assumptions, and explore the mysteries of the physical world. Schrödinger was not the type to simply memorize facts or follow the crowd. He always searched for the why behind the what, preferring deep, thoughtful investigations. This intellectual curiosity led him on a path that would forever change our understanding of the universe. He didn't yet know that his work would one day lay the foundations of quantum mechanics. At that time, the scientific community was struggling to understand the strange and unpredictable behavior of subatomic particles. Unlike classical physics, the newly emerging field of quantum mechanics suggested that particles didn't have a definite position or state until they were measured. This idea became the basis of the Copenhagen interpretation, proposed by physicists Niels Bohr and Werner Heisenberg. They argued that the act of observation itself determines reality. But Schrödinger did not believe this. He found the idea absurd. How could reality depend on whether someone was looking at it or not? He was convinced that quantum mechanics was incomplete in its current form. So, to expose the flaw of the Copenhagen interpretation, he designed a radical thought experiment. Imagine placing a cat inside a completely sealed box. Inside the box, there is also a Geiger counter, a small amount of radioactive material, a vial of poison, and a hammer mechanism. The radioactive material has a 50% chance of decaying within an hour. If it decays, the Geiger counter detects radiation, activates the hammer, breaks the vial, releases the poison, and the cat dies. If it doesn't decay, the cat remains alive. From the perspective of classical physics, the cat must be in one of two definite states, either alive or dead. But quantum mechanics tells us something fundamentally different. Schrödinger's thought experiment can also be expressed mathematically using the wave function. This equation describes the quantum state of the cat. According to quantum mechanics, before observation, the cat exists in a superposition of both alive and dead states. The factor 1 over the square root of 2 ensures that the total probability of all possible states is 1, meaning there is an equal chance of the cat being alive or dead. The cat remains in this uncertain state until the box is opened and the system is measured. The moment we look inside the box, the wave function collapses and the cat is forced into a definite state, either alive or dead. Even though this equation is theoretically correct, real-world objects like cats don't behave this way. This is because of a process called decoherence, where interactions with the environment cause quantum effects to disappear almost instantly. That is why we don't observe such strange quantum behavior in everyday life, even though it occurs at the atomic level. This paradox forces us to question the nature of reality. Does observation determine the state of our system? In fact, we unknowingly experience a similar thought experiment in our daily lives. Every day we face situations where multiple possibilities exist at the same time. But only when we take action does a final result occur. With every choice we make, we are either killing or saving the cat. Imagine you are in love with someone, but don't know if they feel the same way about you. In your mind, two possibilities exist at the same time. They like you back, or they do not. Until you take action and express your feeling, you remain in an emotional superposition. Both outcomes are equally possible. Only when you act and receive a response does one reality become true. Schrödinger was not actually suggesting that a cat could be both alive and dead at the same time. Instead, he designed this experiment to highlight the contradictions within the Copenhagen interpretation. If quantum mechanics applies to everything, then why don't we see such superpositions in our everyday world? This thought experiment exposed a major gap in the understanding of quantum physics at the time. Schrödinger's thought experiment sparked intense debate in the scientific community. Some physicists saw it's a clever way to highlight the limitations of quantum mechanics, while others believed it actually reinforced the core principles of the Copenhagen interpretation. One of the key supporters of the Copenhagen interpretation, Niels Bohr, didn't see Schrödinger's cat as a flaw in quantum mechanics, but rather as a demonstration of its principles. He believed the paradox perfectly illustrated the idea that quantum states remain in superposition until they are measured. Albert Einstein, on the other hand, strongly disagreed. He found the idea of a cat existing in a superposition of being both alive and dead completely absurd and unrealistic. In his letters to Schrödinger, Einstein argued that quantum mechanics was incomplete. He believed that the cat state shouldn't not depend on observation, but rather be determined by some deeper, yet undiscovered, objective reality. Einstein had long opposed the probabilistic nature of quantum mechanics and famously said, "God doesn't play dice with the universe." He believed in the existence of hidden variables, unknown factors that could explain quantum behavior without relying on probabilities and wave function collapse. In his view, the Schrödinger's cat paradox proved that the quantum mechanics needed a more complete and deterministic framework. What if the cat is not in two states at once, but reality itself splits into two versions? In the 1950s, physicist Hugh Everett introduced an alternative explanation known as the many worlds interpretation. According to this idea, instead of collapsing into a single outcome when observed, the universe splits into multiple versions, one where the cat is alive and another where the cat is dead. In this interpretation, both realities exist, but in separate, non-interacting branches of the universe. This revolutionary idea changed the way physicists thought about quantum mechanics and sparked new discussions about the possibility and parallel universe. Applying the many-world interpretation to Schrödinger's cat provides a unique solution to the paradox. Instead of imagining the cat as being both alive and dead in the same reality, the theory suggests that each possibility plays out in a different universe. In one version of reality, the observer opens the box and finds the cat alive. In another version of reality, they open the bags and find the cat dead. Unlike the Copenhagen interpretation, which states that observation determines reality, the many worlds theory suggests that both outcomes happen, but in different universes. Some scientists even speculate that the tiny fluctuations in the first moments after the Big Bang may have led to the creation of multiple universes. If this is true, then our reality is just one of many that have formed. This perspective helps us realize that Schrödinger's cat is not just a thought experiment. It could be a key to understanding how reality truly works. The many worlds interpretation offers a fascinating view of reality. If every decision and event causes a split in reality, then countless versions of ourselves exist in parallel universes, living different lives based on different choices. And yes, in one reality, you are living your best, most ideal life. This also means that in one universe, Schrödinger's cat survives, and in yet another, the experiment never takes place. This idea has not only captivated physicists, but has also inspired writers, filmmakers, and philosophers, leading to discussions on fate, free will, and the nature of existence. Schrödinger's cat is no longer just a thought experiment. It has become a blueprint for cutting-edge science.
Today, physicists are pushing the limits of quantum mechanics, testing how far superposition can go, and the results are just as astonishing as the paradox itself. In the quantum world, scientists have created what they call cat states, not with real cats, but with objects large enough to be seen with the naked eye. These systems exist in two states at once, just like Schrödinger's hypothetical cat. In 2021, a team at Delft University made headlines by entangling a diamond with a qubit. Even though the diamond was small, it contained billions of atoms, yet it behaved quantum mechanically, existing in a superposition of two states. This was a groundbreaking moment, providing that quantum effects are not limited to the microscopic world. What is the ultimate goal? To place a living organism in a superposition.
Yes, you heard that right. A breathing living being existing in two states at once.
In 2020, a team at Oxford proposed an experiment to place a tardigrade, a microscopic nearly indestructible creature, into a quantum state. Though still in its early stages, the experiment raised an astonishing question. Can life itself exist in superposition? And if so, what does that mean for our understanding of consciousness and reality? Scientists are also exploring how quantum mechanics might play a role in biological processes. This emerging field, called quantum biology, suggests that nature may use quantum effects in ways we are only beginning to understand. For example, some birds navigate using the Earth's magnetic field, and researchers believe they might be using quantum entanglement to do so. Similarly, the efficiency of photosynthesis may rely on quantum superposition. If true, this would mean that life itself is more quantum than we ever imagined.
Schrödinger's cat isn't just inspiring new experiments, it's shaping the future of technology.
Quantum computers, which rely on principles of superposition and entanglement, are set to revolutionize fields from medicine to cryptography. Unlike classical computers, which use bits, quantum computers use qubits, which can exist in multiple states simultaneously.
This allows them to solve complex problems exponentially faster.
In 2019, Google claimed quantum supremacy when its quantum computer performed a calculation in 200 seconds that would take a supercomputer 10,000 years to complete. But as we push the boundaries of quantum mechanics, we face even deeper mysteries. Does consciousness play a role in quantum mechanics?
Some theories suggest that observation isn't just passive, but an active force that shapes reality.
Is reality as staged as quantum physics suggests? Schrödinger's cat started as a critic, but it became much more. It remains a symbol of unanswered scientific questions, reminding us that reality may be far stranger than we ever imagined. So, is that cat alive or dead? The answer depends on how you see the universe. Whether the cat is alive, dead, or existing in countless parallel worlds, one thing is certain. The deeper we look into reality, the stranger it becomes.
Schrödinger's cat has left its paw prints, not only on science, but also in our imagination.